feeding means introduction of nutritious food over and above breastfeeding after the 6 months of age. When breast milk becomes insufficient to meet infant's needs, in order to emphasize the importance of complementary feeding and nutrition in child after 6 months of age, we have Dr. Rajgopala S. Sir, HOD, Department of Kamarvati, All India Institute of Ayurveda, New Delhi, today with us. Sir, we all welcome you to this web conference. Professor Rajgopala Sir is a well-known, learned personality in the academic and research field in Ayurvedic pediatrics. He is giving his services since last about 26 years in the field of Kamarvati. Before present position, you served as associate professor at IPGT and RA Jamnagar also. Sir has been in teaching and research front, which includes community in children, including Swarnaprashan, child nutrition, common childhood disorders, etc. Today, sir will explain us about the weaning and artificial feeding. Now, I'd like to Dr. Rajgopala sir to kindly deliver his lecture. Rajgopala sir.
Yeah. Welcome to all. The PPT is visible now, full screen. Pritesh?
Dr. Piyush, kindly make it full screen.
Pritesh?
Yes. Yes, sir.
No, I have to make it. Yeah, it is full screen. Yeah, I will be operating from this side.
Okay.
Respected Kalpana Madam, my teacher, respected Abhimanyu sir, my mentor or Badeva in the field of Kamarvati. Respected other faculty members serving in different institutes all over India from in the Department of Kamarvati, my students and other well-wishers of Kamarvati who are interested in this webinar. Thank you very much the Ayurveda Teachers Association Madhya Pradesh for giving a chance to address you all. After hearing a lucid extempo lecture by Professor Kalpana Madam on breastfeeding, particularly the neonatal period, exclusive breastfeeding issues, benefits and other things. I'm going to talk on weaning and artificial or complementary feeds. The topic is very vast, so I'll be taking clips only, but whatever is important and other things will be highlighted here. Some inputs also will be there for you from research or from international publication side. Okay, to go ahead with the presentation, let me start with what is wean. Weaning has come from the word wean, where it means it is withdrawal. It is not sudden withdrawal, it is gradual reduction or tapering. So meaning means a custom other than its mother's milk. For in case of infants, it is withdrawal from the breast milk in a gradual manner. That is what is meant by weaning. Artificial feeding, or here of course the term given was artificial feeding, so I have written it. Artificial feeding means the process of feeding someone using methods that are not natural. For example, feeding a patient through tube or a baby using a bottle. Of course, it can be a bottle feeding, it can be a spoon feeding, it can be a feeding with the paladai. Paladai is a special spoon which is popular in India, and it is of course a contribution of India to top feeding. Or it may be direct gavage feeding, tube feeding directly into the stomach with a surgical hole or through the oral cavity also. So whatever is not natural, that is artificial. Coming to the first topic, first point of weaning, getting the baby accustomed to other food. Instead of breast milk, it may be other milks. The better term is used complementary feeding, as Ritesh was mentioning and I was mentioning earlier. And essential, why weaning is essential? Because breastfeeding is not complete food for a growing baby. Initial days up to 6 months, yes, it is sufficient. But when baby grow further, the growth and development support, the nutrients present in the milk is not sufficient, quantity also not sufficient. So we require adding other nutritions, other nutritive items. That is introduction of that. As Abhimanyu sir was telling, it should not be a sudden introduction. It should be a gradual introduction. That is that particular process is called as weaning. Ayurveda texts also have understood this concept very clearly, and they have explained kramena apanayasanat. Gradually you have to withdraw from the breast milk and you have to introduce other laghu supachya ahara. If it is delayed, if weaning is delayed, what will happen? it may result into malnutrition. The ultimate will be malnutrition and malnutrition related other complications. And if it is done improperly, what will happen? The very first thing what we see is disturbance in the gastrointestinal tract. That is, either it may be diarrhea or it may lead into constipation, distension of abdomen, and other complaints. Ultimately, it may lead to malnutrition. When we talk of weaning foods, there are a lot of weaning foods available in the market. Infants and children, when it comes to the food concept of infants and children, we have limited source. Exclusive breastfeeding is to be given up to 6 months of age. This is accepted all over the world. At the point when child reaches 4 to 6 months, breast milk is no longer sufficient in terms of quantity as well as quality, both the aspects. Therefore, diet needs to be expanded, and you have to include the easily digestible items along with the breastfeeding as a complement initially, and later it will replace the breast milk itself. Weaning foods, it should be in the semi-solid stage first, because child is accustomed to liquids. The Ayurveda approach is almost same, exclusive breastfeeding up to teeth cut. See, Ayurveda do not say 6 months, Ayurveda explains up to teeth cut. Athayam jata dashanam kramenapanaya stanat. Jata dashanam is very important. Teeth cut. Once teeth eruption starts, then you have to start the weaning process. It should be started with the fruit juices first. Kashyapa very specifically told phalaprashana. Phalaprashana means introduction of fruits. Fruits, again, you have to start with the juices first, and slowly you have to go for the softer fruits like banana and all, and then you can go for the harder fruits. Start with liquids, semi-solids, and then go for the solids. And when you enter into semi-solid, solid stage, the one samskara come in between, that is annaprashana. So generally, annaprashana samskara is done in the 6th or 7th month or 8th month later, and usually at the time of teeth cut and the dentition, starting of dentition. Whatever you give, it should be laghu and brahmana in the beginning. And by 1 year age, the child should consume the homemade normal diet. So that is whatever you cook, the child also should consume. Separate cooking for the child is not encouraged after 1 year of age. That is one input from World Health Organization with regards to Athayanam Jata Dashanam. UNICEF and WHO and other international health agencies also, they have recommended waiting until 6 months of age before starting child on food. The study says, or the information says, that teething shows readiness of digestive system to receive and digest solid foods. That is what Ayurveda also says, Athayanam Jata Dashanam. So Ayurveda concepts are accepted in the Western or in the modern science also. So coming to the traditional weaning foods, Introduction to Nutrition in a book, Gathri has told, traditional techniques of making the weaning foods include malting, germination, soaking. This is the process how it is made. And a lot of weaning foods are there. It is culturally linked in each place. Let us see. I have a list of culturally or weaning foods practiced world over. See, this is the thing. In the continent of Africa, we have 6 continents major where human inhibition living is there. African countries, they have weaning foods. And you can see the item used, the first food what they are using with the maize or millet, potatoes, corn meal, these things they are using. That means all the grains available, abundantly available in that particular place, that is converted into weaning food, which is made light and easily digestible. That is the first food the child receives complementary to the breast milk. Going ahead, South American countries, Brazil, Guatemala, Peru, Dominican Republic, everywhere they have got different kinds of weaning foods. Most of them are dependent upon the grains. Even in our Asian countries like Bhutan, Bangladesh, Nepal, Philippines, yes, here also we have different weaning foods, including America. North America also, they have got weaning food practiced there. Again, it is either millets, cereals, fruits, and vegetables. So traditional foods, even in India, if you go to different places, every culture, every state, every area, they have their own specific practices. If you go to South India, particularly if you go to Kerala, the weaning food will be more of banana based or arrow based. Whereas if you come to North India, it will be more of sattu, grain powder or millet powder based winning force. The common factor what we see all over these places is the Ayurveda principles. Of course, in India, of course, Ayurveda is our culture. So Ayurveda, Deepana, Pachana, these things are already there. As Kalpana Madam was telling, during pregnancy, they give soa processed water throughout the pregnancy period. Similarly, for children, weaning period, they add certain digestive items, spices, along with the food. Cereals, pulses, milk products, sugar. Sugar is added for taste. Earlier days, they were using the mishri, that is sugar candy, to give or jaggery, to give sweet taste to the weaning food. And every home will have a grandmother recipe. And many a times, food is also acted as medicine. If you see Kashyap Samhita, if you see other textbooks of Ayurveda where treatment, chikitsa is mentioned, you may come across with a lot of yavagus, a lot of manda, peya, vilepi, therapeutic diet preparations. If child is having diarrhea, the weaning food, whatever you are giving, if you are adding a little bit of dadim, I'm not talking about the dadima seeds, I'm talking about the bark of fruit bark of the dadim powder, if you are adding, the diarrhea can be controlled. In our place, the South Canara or Karnataka, in our place, we have a practice of storing this dadima fruit rind, dry it and keep it in the house. Similarly, we have a practice of storing putaja flowers and putaja pods, fruit. This will be used in case of diarrhea management, particularly for the children. North India, of course, you have got jati phala and other things for this. So if you categorize these weaning foods, we have malt-based weaning foods, we have chapati-based weaning foods, we have sattu-based, sauti-based, and gruel-based weaning foods. These are all a compilation from different sources. The malt-based, chapati-based, all weaning foods, if you see the ingredients or contents of that, well, most of them are flours. What they do is they do the flour or they make brat, that is a paste of it, and that paste will be diluted with water, they filter it, and then whatever sediments are down, that is a carbohydrate component, that will be taken, dried, and that is stored. And then it will be given with either with ripened banana or with the skimmed milk or with simple milk or simply with the mix with the water. They may add sugar for taste and then it is given to the child. This is the sequence how the weaning foods are prepared and under different ingredients. Cereal-based weaning food also can be prepared. Cereal flour-based weaning food also can be prepared. Bengal gram, that is besan, wheat, gehu based weaning food also can be prepared. That is the sattu, ultimate preparation is. Soti preparation is rhizome of curcuma angustifolia, that is arrowroot, the Indian arrowroot. It is a very good, very light and easily digestible source of energy for growing child. Flour based weaning gruel can be prepared. We are all knowing this, these weaning foods. This is in general about the weaning foods. And weaning to be practiced as a gradual process, not all of a sudden changing. Changing all of a sudden will result into many issues, particular issues. Going ahead with this, artificial feeding supplemented with best feeding and complementary feedings. Artificial feeding, as you know, as I said earlier, it is non-breast-based feeding to the child. It may start right from birth, or it may start later at any time, wherever there is deficiency or wherever there is non-availability of mother's milk. The commonest source world over is cow's milk. And cow's milk as such, we are not supposed to give because of the thickness or density and rich proteins in it. You have to dilute it. Initially, 1:1 ratio for the first month, 2:1 between 1 and 4 months, and no dilution is required after 4 months of age. That means you can give as such. Cow's milk is comparatively thinner and the protein content, other things are less in comparison. Fat content is less as compared to buffalo milk. And buffalo milk is practiced only in Asian subcontinent, I mean Indian subcontinent. If you go to European countries and all, buffalo is not seen. Only cows are seen. Of course, Indian and Western cow breed differences are there. A1 and A2 milk differences are there. That is a different issue, but otherwise it is cow's milk only. To increase the calorie content, you can add sugar, but there is a cautionary note. If you start top feeding or artificial feeding with the highly sweetened milk, the child will not accept the other things because it is practiced to that, and then you will have sugar content, sugar level, you have to maintain the same. This we have to keep in mind. Amount of milk per meal, how much is required? The first 1 or 2 weeks, 60 to 90 ml per day. And as the child age increases, the quantity also goes on increasing. It is shown that 3 weeks to 2 months, 150 ml maximum, 5 months to 12 months, 240. There is around a quarter liter of milk is required. Of course, there are, we have come across with, or we are coming across with the patients or children coming with the liters of milk, taking only milk, only milk. So coming to number of feeds also, how many number of feeds are to be given or preferred? It is also given in the right side of the presentation. The adequacy of intake is assessed by weight monitoring. What we have to monitor is more important thing is the monitoring of anthropometric measurements. Height or length gain, it is predetermined, and there will not be much change in a month or so, but weight, definitely there will be change every day. So weight monitoring is required every week, and you can monitor the weight and fix the dose or fix the quantity of feeds. Coming to the principles of artificial feeding, fruit juices can be started from first month. Artificial, actually this is not phalaprasana or anything related to that. This when you are giving as nutritional supplement. Artificially, babies do not need solid foods such as milk pudding in later months. It is best to prepare milk formula fresh each feeding. This is very important because whenever you are preparing the formula, it should be freshly prepared. Adequate preparation of food, cleanliness of water, bottle, container, utensils, these are very essential items. Bottle and nipples must be first washed well with soap, then using sterilized with boiling water. And then it should be dried proper, wiped clearly. Particularly in the feeding bottle, the problem comes in the threading. Problems comes in the nipple where there will be company print or quantity or specific printing will be there. The ridges of that, the fat molecules gather together, stay, and that becomes a good source for contamination, and that becomes a source for infection. So cleaning is very important. First, you have to wash it well. Generally, what we advise is take 2 bottles, wash it, dry it, and 1 bottle use, the other bottle will be used for the next one. For uneducated mothers, it is best to recommend spoon feeding or paladai. Paladai is a specific spoon, shaped spoon for feeding only. You can feed with in drops to the baby. And nipple hole, this is another thing, should be checked in the artificial feeding bottles. Because if hole is bigger, flow of milk will be more. And again, second thing is milk, if it is not cleaned properly, nipple hole will block and it becomes a source for infections. Supplemented breastfeeding, that is mixed feeding. When child grow further, say like 6 months of age, breast milk is not sufficient. You have to add on to it. Other milks and milk supplements we are adding to it. And main indication for supplementing breastfeeding as an adjuvant is weight gain. As I said earlier, proper weight chart is to be maintained, and based upon that you have to feed the baby, you have to provide nutrition to the baby. The decision of supplementation is taken only after one tries weeks of monitoring. You have to monitor properly, because if you are not monitoring, you will not come to know whether whatever you are giving is proper, it is properly taken or not, and it should be a gradual process. Principle of supplemented feeding further, when there is a need of supplementation, it has to be done, as I said, kramena, gradually. At first, supplementation is given once a day, preferably in the evening hours. A time when mother's milk supply is usually the lowest. There is an observation that evening 6-7 p.m. evening hours, the breast milk secretion is less. This is something like feeding from the right breast first and left breast later, something like that. The baby is breastfed for 5 to 10 minutes. And a supplement formula with the spoon. If baby is not satisfied with supplementation, 2 or 3, that means depending upon the satiation of the child, you have to feed the baby. Spoon feeding is best rather than bottle feeding. Fruit juices may be started after 4 weeks in the supplemented feeding principle, not as a substitute for or not as addition to the breast feeding if breast milk is sufficient. If breast milk is sufficient with the mother, then no artificial feeding, no supplemented feeding should be done till teeth cut or 6 months of age. Complementary feeding is adding, this is what is exactly weaning foods are. It starts 6 to 12 months of age. Breastfeeding is not sufficient for the child at this level. Time of introduction of supplement feed is 6 months, and it should be decided with, again, weight monitoring only. Until it is said that until 9 months breastfeeding is sufficient, and it is a primary diet. Even if you are giving artificial or even if you are giving supplementary feeds, but primary feed will be the breast milk only, because mother-child bond, it's very important, that is called as vatsalya. If there is good vatsalya between mother and child, the child will feel a secure atmosphere and the personality and other things will be better. Foods initially supplement breastfeeding, gradually replace the breastfeeding. That means whatever you are starting, like it may be a sattu or it may be a gruel, initially you are starting, that will slowly replace the breastfeeding. That means you have to reduce the breastfeeding and increase the quantity of the supplementary feeds. If it is early feeding, is we are starting, then what will happen? And if late feeding is there, earlier feeding, decrease of breast milk. As madam was rightly mentioning, vatsalya comes even by hearing of the child, smarana, sparshana, darshana, the things. If it is not there, you are starting supplementary feeds, child stomach is full, you are not feeding the child, then breast milk secretion itself will come down. Other disease conditions or other health conditions like gastroenteritis, indigestion, allergy, malnutrition, other things can come. Late supplementation may result into nutritional deficiency leading to growth retardation, chances of infection, gastroenteritis, malnutrition, other things can happen. There was a study reported from Australia. It was a longitudinal study of more than 5 years. They have taken, they have included more than 5,000 babies into this study, and they studied or they followed the baby with the children up to 5 years of age. And what they have observed is children who are exclusively breastfed for more than 4 months period, the disease conditions, whatever mentioned here, as well as respiratory conditions, respiratory illnesses, were less in comparison to those where the feeding breastfeeding was less than 4 months. Exclusive breastfeeding was less than 4 months. That indicates that breastfeeding definitely is helpful in increasing the immunity, the development of immune system also in the baby. The requirement of energy according to age, as the child, see, initial requirement will be very high, and as the child goes, age increases, the energy requirement slightly comes down. And then supplementation, if it happens, that will take care of it. Supplementary foods must of high energy content, easy to digest. That is what Ayurveda says, supa, chia, laghu, and other things. It should be semi-solid, easy initially. Food are given best by cup and spoon instead of going for bottle feeding and all. And introduced one at a time. You have to start with not that all foods at a time giving. You have to start with one taste at a time, particular variety at a time. When child becomes accustomed to it, then you go on adding the others. Fruit juices, vegetables, boiled, mashed vegetables, egg, meat, etc. All these can be given, but it should be a gradual process. And teeth cut is one of the indications to start supplementation. Some of the points which we have to keep in mind while starting supplementation. Freshly prepared is always preferred, kept in a clean, dry, cool place and away from insects. This is general instruction to all. The choice of food must be done with some flexibility to suit the baby's preference. Some children like spices more, some children like sweet more, some children like sour taste or salty taste. According to their preference, you have to make preference, select the diet. Baby must not be forced to eat. If baby refuses a particular food, hold it for some days, then try to reintroduce it. Forcefully feeding will create problems. some things like spinach, which has got high nitrate content, it should be given fresh soon after preparation. Stored and other things are not advised. Certain variety of beans are not recommended for children because of the allergy. Eggplant is something like your brinjal. That is not recommended in the initial days because of the poor mineral and vitamin contents. It is not that it is not having, but percentage-wise, it is less. Water given to babies younger than 12 months must always must be boiled. It is said that ushnodaka upachari. Ushnodaka doesn't mean that hot water. Boiled cool water should be given. Mixing of boiled water and normal water should not be done. In preparing the food, attention must be paid to the measure of right amounts. See, the amounts are given here. 1 teaspoon means 5 ml. And 1 tablespoon means 15 ml. This is a standard one. Of course, now we get a spoon in between this 5 ml and 15 ml also. And because of various things, we get varieties of spoons. But this is a standard one. 1 cup of glass means 1 cup of or glass of water means 200 ml. and tea, 100 ml. You must be aware of, if you're going in railways and all, you, when you're taking tea, you will get the tea cup, 100 ml. Amount of supplementary feeds per meal, how much it should be given, I have shown here in the, this table in, the, in terms of tablespoon. 6 months may be required, six tablespoons. Six tablespoons means around 90 ml. And what you can give at particular months, that is also given here. What is Ayurveda, that is the same what Ayurveda says, gradual introduction to be done, starting with food juices to solid foods. And by 9 to 12 months, the children to be introduced to the family table. That means in your dining table, you should give a space for the child. Whatever you cook in the house, those things the child also should be able to consume. You have to practice it. This is what this slide says. Children should be trained to self-feed. You have to make them to eat. Let them spill out a little amount, no issue. But train them to eat by self. This increases their concentration, their acceptability, their coordination, and other things. The child introduced the family table. You should sit together. At least one diet a day, a whole family should eat together. And you have to provide a separate plate to the child. That means individuality, it is to be honored. Never force feed the child. Children should not eat candies and sweets frequently, because one is the oral hygiene, and second thing is calorie requirement, it will be more, and digestive problems, worm infestation, these things will be more seen in this condition. Habit forming things like tea, coffee, stimulants should not be given to younger children. This is a general instruction to all. And the very important thing is good eating practice and hand hygiene, washing hands before food, washing hands and mouth after food, keeping the dining table plate clean, and finish the food whatever we have been served to them. These things are to be taught to the children, and good eating practice. These are the weaning foods. Some of them are good baby rice, root vegetables, fruits, and are good things. Starchy items, bakery items are once weaning is established and one digestion is good, then you can add on, and certain things like you can see in the picture, they are not advised at the weaning level. Coming to artificial feeding, the process of feeding someone using method which are not natural, as I said earlier, that is artificial feeding. I'm not going to talk about the surgical means, gavage feeding and other things here. When breastfeeding is contraindicated, like mother is having tuberculosis or having some disease under chemotherapy, she is under drug abuse, herpes simplex inside breast, HIV infection, or when mother do not have sufficient amount of breast milk, then you have to go for the additional or artificial feedings. The very first thing in artificial feeding is breast milk quantity is less than. These are the measures which, of course, Madam Kalpana Madam also explained it. You have to use galactagogues, and then you have to see if galactagogue fails, then you have to go for the alternate things. For artificial feeding, we get three different types of formulas in the market: powdered formula, concentrated liquid formula, and ready-to-use formula. Usually, two sources they are taking. One is milk, particularly cow milk, and another is vegetable milk. Soya-based formulas are getting, cow milk-based protein fortified formulas we are getting in the market, and protein hydrolysate formulas are also available. That means the protein which are present in this am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So sorry for the interruption in the network. It's not in my hand.
No issue, sir. Please continue.
Yeah. Please. 1 minute. Okay. Fortified infant formula feeds, when you see iron fortified infant formulas available in the market, because when top feeding is there, the animal milks are not very rich in iron content, and when baby requires an egg in supplementation, you can go for this iron fortified formula. Then enhanced formulas are available, wherein specific amino acids are added and strengthened. In addition to that, of course, pre and probiotic added milk formulas are also available. That has to be taken when and where required exactly. And early studies are encouraging in this. Long-term benefits of these substances are unknown. That means it is only at trial and experimental level. Of course, iron fortified enhanced formulas are available in the market. There are some risks also. It can increase the chances of diarrhea and infectious diseases. Mixed feeding, especially giving water or other liquids, can cause the supply of breast milk to decrease and baby sucks less as at the breast. That means baby, when stomach is full, then the child will not suck properly, or the child will not show interest in sucking. Babies do not need liquid other than breast milk for 6 months initially if breast feeding is sufficient. Even in hot climates, that is what is told, but it is not my experience, because in hot summer, when there is excess sweating, water loss is high. And when water loss is high, concentration of urine will take place and dehydration features may come, dry skin and other things come. So we may need to give some amount of water, maybe in some mLs like 10 ml, 20 ml a day in the noon hours, but it should be boiled cold water. The risks of artificial feeding, it is not safe again. Artificial feeding, economically, it is very expensive and it carries all risks of additional illness. Illness can lead to any extent. Formula feeding has got these practical challenges. Mother, if they are well versed with the preparation and administration, okay, well and good. If mothers are not, then there are chances of contamination. Contamination in terms of preparation, utensils, feeding, cleaning, all things can happen. And this can be a risk always.
Sir, please share the screen again. Presentation, sir, please.
Yes?
Sir, please share the screen again. Presentation is not displayed.
Okay. 1 minute, there's some issue. 1 minute, hold on. I'll come again. Wait.
Yes, sir.
Just wait a while.
Yes, sir. Now it's visible.
Is it visible? Okay. Formula is not acceptable substitute of breast milk. It is only nutritional component. It is a food only. It is not breast milk as such. Breast milk has got a lot of antibodies, enzymes, long chain fatty acids, hormones, etc., which we cannot supplement with the formulas. First few months, it is hard for the baby to absorb anything other than breast milk. That is another issue. There are two issues. One is from the milk side and another is from the child's gut side. The both should go hand in hand. You have to consider this. This slide is formulas. 21 formulas, so 21 dangers are highlighted here, but not a lot of things too. And these problems can lead to further problems also. See, the classification of age in modern textbook, you can see like this, newborn, neonate, infant, toddler, preschool and all. And if you see Ayurveda books, you can see the classification of ages, Kshirada, Kshiranada, and Annada. The modern classification is based upon the year, age, whereas Ayurveda classification of childhood period is based upon the principal diet. The principal diet of childhood period is milk. That is, Kshirada, it is milk, Kshiranada is also milk, and only in Annada period, the child shifts from milk to other items. Food is important, you know very well about all this. I'll not go to this. Some shlokas explain further the importance of food, ahara, and it is called as Mahabhaishajya. Exclusive breastfeeding is explained from the fourth day to teeth cut, dantodbheda. So that is the best food for the child. And if breast milk is not there, then alternate in Ayurveda, as it mentioned, is Dhatri is the first one. That is again human milk. And then comes the goat, and then comes the cow. And then comes any other milk having similar properties. But when we are going for other than human milk, it is said that sanya bhave payachagam gavyam va tad gunam bibes, having similar properties, and it should be hrisvena panchamulena sthiraya vasitayutam. It should be processed with hrisva panchamula or sthira. They didn't mention dhimana pachana, panchakola or trikatru or something of that. They specifically mentioned hrisva panchamula or sthira. The reason may be the protein content in the milk, to regulate the protein content in the milk, because protein digestion and metabolism excretion takes place through the kidneys. And the it creates a stress on the kidney if you are giving excess of protein. That is called a solute load. Probably, there is no studies on this. Probably this processing milk with Hrisva Panchamula or Sthira it reduces, it helps in stabilizing the protein and strengthening or support for filtration. And Sita, of course, for the taste component and energy component. This is what I have understood with that. Kshira, another condition, athainam jata dashanam, as I said earlier, we have to start the supplementary feeds or supplementary weaning has to be started, and supplementary food items you have to start. In another condition, of course, all terms, all conditions, all mentioned in Ayurveda, those things come into play. Ashtavidahara visheshayatana, dvadasha ashana pravicharana, agni, all these conditions are to be taken into account. And pathya is very important. Apathya to be taken care of. This all depends upon the desha, kala, agni, ahara vyavastha, the family and cultural practices. Samashana, alpashana, deshana, vishamashana, virudhashana, all these things are applicable to children also, right from birth. There is a story, Hitabhuk, Mitabhuk, Kshutabhuk, you know very well about this. And this Hita, Mita and Kshuta, it is applicable to all, including children. Apathya includes atibhojana, anishta bhojana, vishamashana, upavasa, virudhashana, adhyashana, jirna. Yes, we have to avoid this, and ideal food should be acceptable to the child, and it should bestow the child with good health. We have to remember the lehana concept of Kashyapa, because lehana is a supplementation to the breast milk. From 6 months, you can start with all types of food, fruit juices and other things. 6 to 9 months, you can start with the weaning foods like rice-based or wheat-based or suji-based, ragi, millet-based weaning foods. Meshed fruits can be started 1 to 3 spoons in the beginning, and slowly have to increase the quantity. Gradual feeding from family pot, that is what is cooked in the house. And chapati soaked with dal, milk, curd, etc. can be given once teeth cut starts. 4 to 5 weaning diet a day, in addition to regular breastfeeding to be started. And it can be gradually increased. 9 to 12 months of age, again, the quantity goes on increasing. The item also you can add on, like something like idli and other things you can give at this age if child can have a teeth and it can chew it, because it is soft in nature. Kashyapa has given certain food items like Pushtivardhaka Ahara. It is said that Purana Shali, Shastika Shali into Avaleha, by adding Sneha and Lavana, is Pushtivardhaka. Satmi, according to the Satmyata, Goduma and Yava can be given. Yava is, of course, Ruksha. You have to take care of that. Goduma is Guru also. Combination of Vidanga, Sneha and Lavana after cooking, which is also good. If Bhinna Purisha, stool mass is not properly formed, then you can add Kodrava to it. In Pittadhikya condition, Mridvika, Madhusarpi can be. These are all therapeutic as well as weaning diets. Both are together. That is diet as medicine. In Vatadhikya, if it is there, Vatulangarasa and Lavana can be added. As I said earlier, as I've been telling, Deshakala Agni are to be taken care of. So food is a major concern of mankind right from the beginning. And the importance of food is highlighted here. If food is not properly supplied, 4 things can happen. One is undernutrition, imbalance in nutrients, specific deficiency can happen, or overnutrition. Harsha, Sthaulya and other imbalances. These things can happen. And what is that I have explained? I'm just going ahead. This is the status of undernutrition under 5 in India and other nearby countries. The world population says underweight is 27%, wasting 10%, and stunting, as shown in the slide, 31%. The causes of malnutrition is highlighted in this slide. Primary cause, like due to dietary deficiency, economic condition, ignorance, medical reasons, large family, closely spaced families, working mother, and a bad start. Secondary conditions include varieties of diseases. In this slide, of course, how this bad economic condition, ignorance, medical reasons will lead to malnutrition, and malnutrition related other further complications is explained. Secondary causes like diseases, they can also lead to poor health and increased demand, less supply, definitely lead to deficiency conditions. How to prevent this malnutrition? Protein energy malnutrition is a broad term comprising of 5 different disease specific conditions. It can be prevented. Our intervention can be initiated at 3 levels. One is individual, that is at home level. Second is community level, and third is national level. At individual home level, good nutrient diet, proper weaning. First thing is breastfeeding and then proper weaning. Improve family diet quality and quantity. Appropriate immunizations to be given to prevent other illnesses. Impose no restriction feeding during illness. Family planning and spacing to be advised. These are all to the parents and family. And child must get good nutrient-rich food item. At community level, early detection of malnutrition and interventions, integrated health packages, nutritional education to the parents and society as a whole, promotion of education and technological measures. That is one of the examples. Of course, this is a debatable thing, like adding iodine to salt, distribution of iron folic acid tablets, vitamin A distribution for preventing night blindness and other things. At national level, we have got nutrient supplementation programs, survey programs are taking place, plannings are there, and which leads to national nutrition programs like this, Balawadi nutrition program and midday meal program, ICDS program and all. Many of these programs are successful in many states, and the success depends on how they have implemented it. And some of the states have not accepted this, and you might have read about the results of that. It is a state level nutrition. Other than this, of course, there are state level nutrition programs too. Like in midday meal program, in some states they give egg as a part once in a week or twice a week, whereas in some states they give fruits as a part. This is a state issue. However, these programs are helping a lot in controlling the malnutrition issues. There are four or five specific nutrient or protein rich supplementation the government supports, like Besan Laddu, Suji Kheer, Hyderabad Nutrition Mix, Shakti Ahar, many other. Each state have their own preparations. I think Madhya Pradesh has got, again, some districts they have tried with the fortifying with Ashwagandha and other things. Now going on to the studies on Brahmana nutrition supplements, this is our experience. More than 15 studies in Jamnagar and one study at All India Institute of Ayurveda also we have conducted. Ayurveda nutrition mixture with Balia beans, Vacha Dhatriya Javali have our Brahmana activity. Rinana Modaka, Paushtika Biscuit. Of course, Paushtika Biscuit, I think now in Jamnagar, they are conducting an extended study on this in comparison to Hyderabad Nutrition Formula with and without Deepana, Pachana, and other things. In All India Institute, of course, we have study on Vidaryadi granules. Of course, all these things have given a promising response, not in 1 year child, but in 3+ year children. Some cautionary notes. Ashwagandha, Shatavari, Vidari, Musali, Masha, we are highlighting them as Balya and Brahmana Dravyas. Agreed. They are Vrishya Vajikarna drugs. That is also agreed. But can we use all these things in children? This is a question. Because Ashwagandha has got androgenic stimulating, Shatavari has got estrogenic stimulating activity. We have seen in one of the studies in infertility in Jamnagar where Musali was given and gynecomastia developed in adults. So what will be the case of children? So inducing these hormonal changes, early onset of puberty, all these things can happen if we are not using the drugs unjudiciously. So judicious use is required, proper care is required. As I've been telling, I told earlier, the monitoring of weight, the developmental milestones, these are very essential when you are planning for nutrition supplementations. Now going ahead, this is only an item to your thinking. Aharo Mahavaishajyam and Aharo Mahavisha. Now the present status is Aharo is becoming Visha also. These are highlighted here. I'm not reading all these things. Just these are the clips from newspapers, daily, almost weekly supplementation. We can see these things. 45% of Mumbai milk is likely to be adulterated. The milk supply to Delhi from Kanpur and other area are adulterated with urea. One of my colleagues had suffered from this. This is the status of your Parmal, pointed gourd. If you wash it, the color comes out. Natural Parmal, of course, the color will not go. This is the status. The world status and India, where we stand, you can see. No, of course, slightly we are ahead, but there are countries like China and Mexico with us, behind us. It is world over. It is an issue of every country. This slide also explains the same. Chemicals in food. Varieties of chemicals like chlordane, endrin, heptachlor, ethyl parathion, these things they use for coloring. And the lychee fruit, what we are getting in Delhi today, if you wash it in water, you can have red water. You can imagine. The rice, the red rice, Rakta Shali is said to be the very good one. So to make the Shali red, Rakta, to make Shali red, they add lead sulfate solution. They dip the rice in lead sulfate, sulfate solution and then dry it and send it. If you wash the rice, lead sulfate will go off. This is what is happening. Food fraud. Nutraceuticals is a very, very fast growing industry in the world over. And of course, we are leaders in it, export of nutraceuticals to the world. And food fraud is the issue. Baby food is not an exception for this. You have a lot of baby foods in the market. A lot of them are there. I don't want to say the names or highlight the names here. But the Center for Scientific and Public Interest, this is an organization of USA. What they have studied is this. Investigations of misleading labeling in the infant and toddler food industry. Consumers were commonly misled to the believing they purchased nutritious foods. In reality, many of the infant and toddler foods are not nutritious and are comprised predominantly cheaper sugar-laden ingredients like applesauce or concentrated grape juice. This is what we see. So food fraud is a rampant world over. On the other hand, we have a lot of cultural traditional practices with us. Some of them are very good practices, the weaning foods. Some of them are harmful practices, like some Agnikarma procedures they are doing. Some amulets and other things they tie around the body and other things. Such things to be discontinued. One of the best examples is application of tea powder or cow dung into the umbilical cord. Yes, it is not a good practice. It should be curtailed. And some of the practices like wearing something or putting some onto the face or body, harmless practices, you can encourage them. Nityam Kshira Ghritabhyasa. This has to be, we are losing this. Ghee increases the cholesterol, not good. Honey, adulterated honey, we are getting, not good. Milk, adulterated milk, we are getting, not good. No, not, that is not the thing. If source is good, this is very good. All these three, milk, ghee, as well as honey, they have proven immunomodulators. They boost your immunity. They boost the immunity of the child also. So it is a best practice which can be done. The world over, we have got varieties of foods and varieties of food practices or varieties of weaning practices too. Identify them, good things support, bad things curtail. If you feel that it is inert, you can support for the psychological benefits. The conclusion of the presentation is breastfeeding is the best feeding. Weaning should be started with proper planning. There is so much diversity in traditional health foods in India. Because of the regional health foods are evolved according to the climate, culture and cropping practices of a particular region. It is experience-based. Ayurveda itself is experience-based science. The need of the hour is to scientifically document the health benefits of traditional foods across the various regions so that this precious knowledge will be preserved for the coming generation. That means all the weaning foods to be recorded and to be practiced and encouraged. This is what I want to say. An ideal nutrition supplementation when you're planning, it should have 60 to 70% of carbohydrate component, 20 to 30% of protein component, and 10% at least of the fat component. This makes the food complete. Source is immaterial. Whatever regional sources are there, that can be taken. It can be fortified with the Brahmana, Balya, Rasayan, and Medhya drugs if possible, so that it will have better outcome. Digestion will be better, assimilation will be better, and other outcomes also will be there. Agni is very important. It is not that only adults we have to consider Agni. Agni starts from right from the beginning. And we have to consider the Agni. If Agni is good, digestion metabolism will be good. Assimilation will be good. Growth and development also will be good. The nutrient formulation, however nutrient it is, if Agni is not good, it will not be used. It will be putting it simply into the drain. So with these words, I can conclude my presentation. And my thanks. Dr. Lokesh and all who have directly, indirectly helped me in getting this presentation, and to all your audience, the queries are welcome. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your nice informative lecture. Sir, we have some queries. Can we take, sir?
Yeah, okay, no problem.
Sir, this query was raised from Dr. Shweta Jaiswal. She was asking that in absence of breast milk, how can we fulfill the proper demands of vitamins in body?
See, in the absence of that is what I'm telling. The best substitute for breast milk is other animal milks. Human milks best substituted other animal milks. There is slight variation in the nutrients of animal milk and breast milk because milk is particularly for its progeny. Cow's milk is for the calf, not for human beings. And it will not be suitable one. So whatever deficiency is there, that has to be supplemented. If you remember, of course, it is a general practice even today also. When the baby is out, delivery is over and the baby is out from the hospital, they give a bottle of one or two bottles of different vitamins, fat soluble vitamins particularly. And it has to be supplemented. You can supplement with the natural source or you can supplement from the other chemical source also. Thank you, sir.
This query was raised from Dr. Mahesh Chandra from Facebook live page.
Yeah.
He's a bit confused, I think, but kindly listen to the query. He's asking that Annaprashan Sanskar is done at the age of 10 to 12 months, but the age of another child is after 2 years.
Yeah.
Kindly clear the confusion.
Yeah, there's no confusion in it. Annaprashana doesn't mean that the child is put on Anna totally. Annaprashana Samskara is initiation of or starting of solid foods. Okay. It can be started at 8 months or 10 months or 1 year. But in the same this thing, Kashyapa says by 1 year he should eat normal diet. All our acharyas are telling the same thing. It is a gradual process. Samskara is a ritual process giving a ritual touch to it to get the social acceptance and importance to it. So it doesn't have annada means totally on solid foods. Annada is not referring to the child is not taking milk. 3-year-old child also drinks milk. It is not the principal diet, that's all. Okay, that is a confusion only, nothing else. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Sir, there was one other query from Dr. Shipra from Facebook. Actually, it's not related to our topic. But she was asking that Drohed Vimanaj Janya Garbhaj Vikrati.
Dauhrada Avamana Janya Garbhaja Vikrati.
Yeah.
What she want to know about it?
She was asking about how can we explain these vyadis in present scenario?
See, psychoneuroendocrine endocrinology. Yeah, it is a new subject. The influence of psychological factors into the general health, psychic health as well as physical, psychosomatic health. It is a new thing. So anything can happen. If you start thinking that you are having fever continuously in the corona period, what we call it as first year syndrome, second year syndrome and all, if you keep constantly thinking on that, you will have it. Dauhrada avamana means constant thinking of a constant stimulus to one particular thing, it will result into some outcome. It is possible. We may not be able to explain today in the definite terms, but there are studies where mother's psychological status influencing the child. You can see USG based or color Doppler studies on expression of the fetus to external stimulus. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Sir, one viewer is asking about Deepan Pachan drugs in infants.
Yeah.
To name a Deepan few. Pachan drugs.
You can use all Deepan Pachan drugs in infants. The only question is about the dose. In what quantity you are using it? There is no specific contraindication for the Deepan Pachan, but the only thing is about the dose, what you are using. Certain Ushna Tishna Dravyas are better avoided. So that is the reason why Panchakola is mentioned in Vamana, Pitam Pitam Vamati Yahastanyam Tam Madhusarpisha Dvi Varta Ki Palarasam Panchakolam Cha. Panchakola they have used there. Shunti Rasa, Adragaswarasa along with honey. Yes, it is used for improving digestion or hunger.
Thank Chitraka you,
cannot be used. Yes. Yeah, please.
Thank you, sir. Rest queries will be mailed to you, sir, after this webinar. Thank you so much, sir, for your nice informative lecture. Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you, the organizers, and as well as for you, sir, and all audience.
Thank you, sir.
Very much.
Now I would like Dr. Lokesh to proceed further. Dr. Lokesh.
Thank you, Jitesh. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Kalpana ma'am. Thank you, Rajgopal sir. मैं डॉक्टर धर्मेंद्र शर्मा जी, एचओडी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमार्बिट गवर्नमेंट आयुर्वेदिक कॉलेज इंदौर को इनवाइट करूंगा कि वो सत्र को कंक्लूड करें। डॉक्टर धर्मेंद्र शर्मा सर।
जी सर, सभी को नमस्कार। आरोग्य टीचर्स एसोसिएशन ऑफ इंडिया मध्य प्रदेश इकाई और आरोग्य मित्र समिति के तत्वावधान में आयोजित कुमार भृत्य विषय के अंतर्गत न्यूट्रिशन इन इन्फेंसी विषय पर आधारित वेब कॉन्फ्रेंस में उपस्थित मुख्य अतिथि परम आदरणीय गुरुजी प्रोफेसर अभिमन्यु कुमार जी, जो वर्तमान में राजस्थान आयुर्वेद विश्वविद्यालय जोधपुर में वाइस चांसलर के गरिमामय पद पर सुशोभित है और अपने विषय के प्रकांड विद्वान है, और सौभाग्य से मुझे उनका प्रथम शिष्य होने का सौभाग्य भी प्राप्त है राष्ट्रीय आयुर्वेद संस्थान जयपुर में, मैं उनको सादर प्रणाम करता हूँ। आपके निर्देशन एवं मुख्य आतिथ्य में हुई इस वेब कॉन्फ्रेंस के मुख्य वक्ता आदरणीय प्रोफेसर कल्पना पटेल मैडम जो जामनगर से हैं, एवं आदरणीय डॉक्टर राजगोपाल सर जो ऑल इंडिया इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ आयुर्वेद नई दिल्ली से हैं, उनको भी मेरा सादर प्रणाम। आज के इस वेबिनार में मुझे कंक्लूजन का एक महत्वपूर्ण जिम्मेदारी सौंपी गई है। आज के इस वेबिनार में एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण विषय पर जो आपने व्याख्यान दिए, माननीय आदरणीय गुरुजनों के जो व्याख्यान सुनने को मिले, वाकई बहुत ही ज्ञानवर्धक रहे। आदरणीय कल्पना मैडम ने जो ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग पर जो व्याख्यान अच्छी प्रकार से समझाया, ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग से रिलेटेड जो भी बारीकियां थी उनके हर पहलू को बहुत ही अच्छे से समझाया। वास्तव में ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग की जो इम्पोर्टेंस है या जो टेक्निक्स है या जो ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग की टाइमिंग्स हैं, उन सभी के बारे में केवल आयुर्वेद विशेषज्ञ या जो कुमार भृत्य के जो विशेषज्ञ हैं या जो चिकित्सा समुदाय है केवल वो ही नहीं जाने, सभी माताओं को इसके बारे में पता होना चाहिए। सभी माताएं इसके बारे में इसके लिए अवेयर होनी चाहिए। ये ज्ञान वाकई इतना महत्वपूर्ण है कि इसके लिए क्या है कि जो माताओं को अच्छे से ज्ञान होगा तो शिशु पालन में किसी प्रकार के कोई कठिनाई नहीं आएगी और शिशु अनेक प्रकार के संक्रमणों से बचा रहेगा और उसकी जो ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट है उसमें किसी प्रकार की कोई दिक्कत नहीं आएगी। और दूसरा जो व्याख्यान है डॉक्टर राजगोपाल सर द्वारा जो दिया गया, वीनिंग एंड आर्टिफिशियल फीडिंग, वाकई ये भी एक बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट विषय था। और विनिंग जो शब्द है बच्चों के लिए काफी कठिन है, वैसे विनिंग शब्द स्तन्य अपनयन के नाम से आयुर्वेद में बताया गया है, स्तनों से उसको दूर ले जाना, स्तन्य पान से उसको दूर ले जाना, तो ये बच्चे के लिए भी बहुत कठिन है। बच्चा इसको आसानी से छोड़ता नहीं है और नहीं छोड़ना चाहता है, माताओं को बहुत ही जतन करने पड़ते हैं इसके लिए कि वो जैसे तैसे स्तनपान करना छोड़े। इसके लिए बहुत सारे प्रयास भी करती है मदर, आयुर्वेद में अष्टांग संग्रह में हृदय में बताया भी गया है कि दूध छुड़ाने के लिए माताएं अपने स्तनों पे कई सारे लेपों सहारा लेती है, जैसे वो महावर है, लाक्षा है या सिंदूर है, ताकि वो बच्चे को रक्त का आभास हो उसको, कि कृत्रिम व्रण बना करके उसको डराया जाए उसको, ताकि बच्चा आसानी से स्तनपान करना छोड़ दे। लेकिन फिर भी कई बच्चे वाकई बहुत ही हटी किस्म के रहते हैं तो नहीं छोड़ते तो, लेकिन उसका नुकसान भी है, जैसे आपने बताया कि डिले विनिंग और अर्ली विनिंग दोनों का ही अपना अपना नुकसान है। और खास तौर से एक महत्वपूर्ण बात ये बताना चाहूँगा मैं सर, कि आपने जो बताया है कि अष्टांग संग्रह का या जो वाग्भट जी ने जो बताया, अथेन जात दशनम क्रमश अपनयत स्नाथ गुरुवक्त योजितम क्षीरम अन्नम च लघु ग्रहणम, वाकई ये जो अथेन जात दशनम जो बताया है कि दंतोत्पत्ति होने के पश्चात ही उसको विनिंग या आर्टिफिशियल फीडिंग पे लाना चाहिए, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीज बताई है। जात दशनम यानी कि जब दंतोत्पत्ति हो जाए तो उसके बाद में मदर को भी स्तनपान कराते समय बड़ा कष्ट होता है, कई बार दांत चुभ देता है तो ब्रेस्ट इंजरी होने की संभावना बहुत ज्यादा रहती है, और साथ ही ब्रेस्ट इंजरी तो साथ रहने की संभावना रहती रहती है, और उसको न्यूट्रिशनल डिफिशियंसी भी उसको साथ में हो जाती है अगर उसको अगर उस समय नहीं करवाएंगे उसको ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग। तो अथेन जात दशनम ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ बताई है। इसके साथ साथ ही उसको जो सेमी सॉलिड्स सॉलिड्स के माध्यम से जो वेडिंग करते हुए सेमी सॉलिड्स का जो इंट्रोड्यूस करवाना है तो बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट होता है उसकी ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट के लिए, बच्चे को अच्छे से सर्वाइव करने के लिए। तो सर आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, आप दोनों वक्ताओं का काफ़ी धन्यवाद, और साथ ही इस आपके इस मार्गदर्शन में ये वेबिनार सफलतापूर्वक संपन्न होने जा रहा है और आपसे भविष्य में भी हम आपका सहयोग की अपेक्षा रखते हैं, आपका आशीर्वाद हमें हमेशा मिलता रहेगा। इस वेबिनार में हमारे ऑर्गेनाइजिंग चेयरमैन डॉक्टर रवि कुमार श्रीवास्तव जी जबलपुर से, डॉक्टर आर पी तिवारी जी रीवा से जो सब्जेक्ट कोऑर्डिनेशन टीम के एक्सपर्ट भी हैं मेरे साथ, और इस वेबिनार के जो मॉडरेटर है डॉक्टर रितेश वर्मा जी जिन्होंने बहुत ही अच्छे से मॉडरेशन का कार्य किया है, ग्वालियर से हैं वो, और आयुर्वेद टीचर्स एसोसिएशन के ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी डॉक्टर लोकेश जी रीवा, इनका प्रयास बड़ा सराहनीय रहा। और जो नेशनल टीम है आयुर्वेद टीचर्स एसोसिएशन, इस नेशनल टीम के जो प्रेसिडेंट है डॉक्टर राहुल सूर्यवंशी और सेक्रेटरी मनोज चौधरी जी, इनका भी सहयोग योगदान बाकी सराहनीय रहा, इनका बहुत बहुत आभार व्यक्त करते हुए और सभी को धन्यवाद करते हुए मैं अपनी वाणी को विराम देता हूँ। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू सर। कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन है मैं चाहूँ